Welcome to Windows 8. It looks a lot like Windows 7. You'll see your time, date, calendar, some of the icons of the various programs that can run down in the bottom right corner, your recycle bin and other shortcuts that you can create on here. Of course, it comes with nothing, just like Windows 7. And the icons, which you can add others down by the bottom here, you got Internet Explorer and your file browser to get to your documents, music, pictures, and so on. Just like Windows 7, it looks exactly the same. Okay, you got your documents and music, pictures, videos, and so on. It looks the same. The only major difference is the start menu. There is no start menu that will pop up. You go down here and start pops up. You click on start and then this is what you got, is this big splash screen, which is how Windows starts. It will actually start a little before that, where you gotta log in, and I've already logged in, and you've got all these tiles or live tiles, and you can move them around, organize them how you like. And you can turn them on and off. If you turn off the live tiles, it just shows a placeholder of what that is, and you can see it's photos. So if I right click on it, I can turn it on or off, and it points to the pictures folder, and whatever it sees in there, it displays that as a picture slideshow. Of course, you got weather, stocks, all kinds of other stuff that you can turn on and off and do different things with. But you want to get down to the main meat and potatoes of the program. You want to launch a program, so get over here and open Word, Excel, one of these programs. As you install programs, this is where they're all going to plop themselves in. But you may not see all the programs that you're looking for. So how do you get to the rest of the start menu, or the rest of the programs? Right click anywhere on the screen, and there's all apps in the bottom right. Click on that, and you're going to see a list of all the programs. There's the other apps that you can add to the main screen, some of which you already saw, other programs sorted by the manufacturer, and then moving on down is where a lot of people will say, how do I get to certain things like the command prompt, control panel. They're all in here. There is no easy way to close out. There's no X button or anything like that. You can right click on here and go to all apps. Takes you back to this screen, and then you can click on the desktop tile here to take you back to the desktop. And that's basically it, going back and forth. Some of the shortcuts you can see if you right click on the start button. Here's a shortcut to all the different things like the device manager and the command prompt, task manager, control panel. Moving the mouse up to the top right corner of the screen, and you've got searching capabilities and other things that you can do, which you can experiment with and see what other personalization you can do, and there's a lot of stuff. Going back to the start menu, if we just open up Internet Explorer, you might find from here one of the big things that you might want to know about is if you open Internet Explorer from the start menu, you're going to find it's a lot different from opening it from the desktop. If you open Internet Explorer from the start menu, it's going to have the address bar along the bottom. Now, the other thing I don't like about this, not only it's on the bottom, it's just weird and awkward and where's my favorites, and launching another program again. Now you can go down to the bottom right corner and there's your start menu, or you can just hit the Windows key on your keyboard and that does the same thing and takes you back here. And if you look up here, move your mouse up to the top left corner of the screen, you'll see all the live applets that are open. So I want to go back to my desktop, and I want to open Internet Explorer from here because I just like it better that way. Okay, so we got Internet Explorer on the desktop open, but we're using more system resources now because we still have Internet Explorer open from the start menu. So again, if we move the mouse up to the top right, the top left corner of the screen, we can see any applets that are open, which currently is showing Google on here. If we right click on that, we got the option to close, and now we just close that live tile that was open. So now we don't have two instances of Internet Explorer running. Aside from that, your favorites menu and everything else is all the same as it used to be. And that's pretty well it. We'll get some more videos with some detailed instructions on how to do certain things with Windows 8, but for now, this was your overview.